जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19। The Jammu and Kashmir government is arranging special trains for its residents stranded across the country due to the lockdown and will bear the cost of the tickets even as 30,000 people have so far returned to the UT with proper regulation, the Home Department said on Friday. It said the Jammu and Kashmir government has decided to bear the cost of the tickets. However, it said nobody should move in a hurry without passes issued with the consent of the J&K government. Curfew-like restrictions have been imposed across the Kashmir Valley on Friday to maintain law and order as authorities apprehended street protests against the killing of Hizbul Mujahideen chief Riyaz Naiku in an encounter with security forces. Concertina wires and heavy deployment of security forces personnel dotted the road around densely populated areas of the city and elsewhere in the valley to ensure the only people with movement passes were out of their home. Laborers of J&K's largest factory Chenab textile mill at Kathua on Friday resorted to violence and blocked the Jammu-Pathankot highway to protest the non-payment of full wages amid the ongoing lockdown. Thousands of workers assembled at workers' colony inside the factory and staged a noisy demonstration against the management after they came to know that they have allegedly been paid half of their monthly wages due to the lockdown. Over 700 Kashmiris who were stranded in different parts of the country due to lockdown amid COVID-19 breakout have reached the summer capital, taking the total number of returnees to 1,300 during the last 48 hours. Deputy Commissioner Srinagar Shahid Iqbal Chaudhary on Friday said that 700 people stranded outside the UT reached Srinagar on Thursday night. The Indian Army on Friday gave a befitting reply in response to the firing by Pakistani forces in the Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir. According to latest inputs, at least 3 to 4 soldiers of Pakistani forces have reportedly been killed and 5 are said to have been injured in the retaliatory firing by Indian Army. The Indian troops also inflicted heavy firing on Pakistani army posts and damaged them. An entire floor of the civil secretariat in Srinagar was cleared and disinfected after an employee posted there tested positive for COVID-19 2 days ago. The employee, a resident of the Shafapura area in Gandharbal district, was found COVID positive on Wednesday, prompting the authorities to clear the floor where he was working. A disinfection drive was carried out in the secretariat building, which houses offices of the top brass and administration and bureaucracy of Jammu and Kashmir. Deputy Commissioner Srinagar Shahid Iqbal Chaudhary dismissed reports in some sections of the media about the civil secretariat being closed. A special flight carrying 167 medical students hailing from Jammu and Kashmir arrived in Srinagar from Bangladesh capital Dhaka on Friday as part of the center's efforts to bring back Indians stranded abroad. Officials said the students were undergoing screening at the airport, after which they will be sent to administrative quarantine for a period of 14 days as mandated under the guidelines issued for curbing the spread of COVID-19. Srinagar Deputy Commissioner Shahid Iqbal Chaudhary expressed his gratitude to the Indian High Commission in Dhaka for the tremendous efforts in getting these students home. A MiG-29 aircraft of the Indian Air Force crashed at Chuhadpur village of Shaheed Bhagat Singh Nagar on Friday. The pilot ejected from the plane at Hoshiarpur district's Rorki Khas village before the aircraft crashed. The aircraft crashed after it developed a technical snag. A court of inquiry has been ordered to investigate the cause of accident. The Supreme Court on Friday suggested that states should consider indirect sale and home delivery of liquor as per its statute and law to avoid crowding at liquor shops amid the ongoing coronavirus-induced lockdown. The top court, after hearing the petition complaining about flouting of safety norms at liquor shops, observed that it cannot pass any orders to different states, but they should consider online sale and home delivery of liquor. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi said on Friday that the government needs to tell people about its strategy to open up the country as well as the economy after the COVID-19 lockdown ends on May 17th. The former Congress president also talked about the coronavirus disease COVID-19, which has triggered the nationwide lockdown. He said that barring a few category of people, the disease is not dangerous.
आप किसी भी बिजनेस वाले से पूछें तो वो आपको बताएंगे कि जो हमारी सप्लाई चेन है वो रेड येलो एंड ग्रीन, रेड ऑरेंज एंड ग्रीन सिस्टम के बीच में से निकलती है।
Union Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday inaugurated 75-kilometer long Kailash Mansarovar road link in Uttarakhand's Pithorgarh through video conferencing. With this move, the Indian security post at Indo-China borders in Vyans Valley of Pithorgarh district is now connected with the rest of the country via a 75.54-kilometer long road from Ghati Bagar in Darchulla to Lipulekh near the border with China.